Good morning, everybody. So, this chapter 4, actually, we covered briefly for the lab. So, we'll go this part rather quickly, right? So, let's go to my MOSFET first. Where is my MOSFET? I have too many. Actually, this is only for homework, maybe. Where is my MOSFET part? It doesn't finish. Many of them, right? Well, you have a lot of Chinese character here too. Many of them. Okay, let's go to the MOSFET. MOSFET stands for metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. So it shows you the structure. So it has metal for the gate. This is my gate material. Actually, okay, and then I have a oxide. This oxide is silicon oxide. Okay, actually this oxide is just silicon, SiO2, okay? Silicon is I think this is something like that. This part is I'm not sure, okay? All right. So, and then silicon. Semiconductor. So that's a structure of a MOSFET. Okay. So this gate material is can be made of metal or polysilicon. This polysilicon is this is a polycrystalline silicon. Okay. Polycrystalline silicon. Yeah, it says it's a polycrystalline. It's not single crystal. Usually, silicon wafer is just a single crystal. The entire wafer is has just a regular crystal structure. This is polycrystalline silicon. Silicon has a it's a single crystal in that part, and that's a combination of single crystals. So this gate can be made of metal or polysilicon. So you know this is a photo of MOSFET. Say I have a source drain and then gate. So this is a metal. Let's just see. My MOSFET is mostly made of like that. This is my gate. And I have a source, drain. Yeah, this is my drain. This is my source. This is my gate. And also, I have a bulk contact. This bulk can be just a substrate, okay? This is my substrate. And this source is actually, it's a supplier. It supplies free carriers, okay? Supplies. Something like that, okay? Gate. So, I have a depletion region here. It has no free carrier depletion region. And then see, in the P-type silicon, I have let us see. No. I have a group 3 group 3 acceptor and free carrier, right? Free hole. That's electrically neutral p-type substrate. In this depletion region, I don't have a free electron. I just have those ionized fixed acceptor only, right? No free carrier in the depletion region. And here, see, I have a free electron. Those are free electrons, right? They are free. See, this is a free electron. Free electron. So, this gate voltage, I will apply gate voltage here. That gate voltage will generate this electric field, right? The amount of electric field controls the amount of inversion charge in the channel, okay? So, if I see, this is a N-channel MOSFET. In the N-channel MOSFET, free electrons are used for the conduction, for the current conduction, okay? So, you know, though, see, this is, so here, see, this substrate is P-type. Somehow, I have a N-type free carrier. You know, in the P-type silicon, I have a lot of free holes, right? But here, see, this P-type substrate suddenly becomes N-type here. So this is called channel inversion. Okay, channel inversion. We say this is inversion channel. You know, P-type substrate is inverted to N-type. So I have many free electrons available for current conduction, all right? So this one supplies those free electrons. Source supplies the channel carriers. This drain, say actually this drain is it's just drain. Drain means this one. It takes away those free electrons. Okay, so it supplies the free electron, and it takes away, drain takes away those free electrons. So drain is more positive, right, in potential. So it just pulls free electron, okay? If I increase this gate voltage, then it increases this vertical electric field, okay? This, you know, this is a field effect, right? Field. This electric field means that electric field on this vertical electric field at the surface of silicon and oxide, okay? So this is my field effect transistor. Field effect transistor. So any question? Nope. Okay, so we need this gate source voltage, you know, this actually gate channel voltage. Gate source voltage is the voltage drop between gate and this source, right? Those gate source voltage must be larger than threshold voltage to make an inversion channel, okay? To invert the P-type into N-type at the surface. Yeah. So, what's the channel inversion? This channel inversion means, see, I start with a P-type silicon, P-type substrate. P-type substrate. Then, you know, at the interface, at the silicon oxide interface. Here, see, suddenly this p-type is inverted into n-type. Okay, then it can support a lot of free electrons. Okay, it can keep free electrons because it's inverted into n-type. Okay. Yeah, how can it happen? See, that's because of electric field on the surface. Okay, this is oxide. Oxide, oxide. How can I write oxide? Yeah, this is my oxide. This is oxide, something like that. And this is a silicon. So this is a gate. Yeah, if I apply large gate voltage here, then this gate voltage will push away those free holes. This free hole will be pushed away into substrate in this silicon region below oxide. Okay. Then, so if I increase this gate voltage into more positive value, then this depletion region will be extended. So I will have a larger depletion region as gate voltage is increased. Then, if there is this net charge here, that net charge density is Na, which is acceptor concentration. This negative charge will develop a electric field. Okay. Negative charge itself will develop electric field, and then see, and then if this depletion region is large enough, then the potential, this electric field will generate some potential difference, which is silicon potential. If this silicon potential reaches 2 pi f, the built-in potential, then I can keep this type can become n-type. Okay. I increase the gate voltage, and then I have some depletion region developed below the oxide. Then that depletion charge generates electric field. If that electric field is large enough, I mean the potential difference across this depletion region becomes 2 pi f, then this surface can support free electron. This free electron came from source. Okay? Source supplies those free electrons for the channel. These free electrons are free to move, so it can move by the electric field by the drain. The drain voltage is positive. Drain can pull those free electrons in the channel. Okay? So yeah, drain takes away because this is positive. Yeah, question. Yeah. pi f라는 것은 그 PN 장시간하고 관계가 있는데요. 오케이, okay, let's look consider PN junction. So I have electrically neutral p-type here, which has acceptor and free hole, and there is a donor and free electron. In here, see, they are depleted across the junction, right? So here, see, there will be electric field by those depletion charge. This depletion charge will generate a potential difference, right? And that potential difference thing is this is a potential difference, right? That's 2 pi f, which corresponds to Vt log doping is mdNa. Yeah, this is that 2 pi f, built-in potential, right? So, you know, here, see, because of this electric field, those free electrons cannot move to the drain because the electric field pulls away, right? Those free electrons on the N side cannot move toward P by this built-in electric field. So those built-in electric field 2 pi f isolates free charge in the PN junction, right? Similarly, in a MOSFET, see, those free electrons on the surface and those free holes in a substrate, they cannot move by this electric field, right? If that electric field is large enough, the potential difference across this depletion region reaches 2 pi f. It isolates free electron on the channel and free hole in the substrate. Yeah, question. Yeah.그렇진 않죠. 그러니까 그건 지금 서멀 제너레이션 하면은 그 말이 맞지. 프리 일렉트론 한 개하고 프리 일렉트론 프리 홀 한 개가 하면 서멀 제너레이션은 그렇게 되죠. 저 서멀 제너레이션이라는 것은 실리콘 저기 결정에 붙어 있는 발렌스 일렉트론을 때려 가지고 그 발렌스 일렉트론이 프리 일렉트론 되고 그 발렌스 일렉트론 자리에 프리 홀이 하나 있으면은 프리 일렉트론 덴스티 이퀄 프리 홀 덴스티하고 같아지죠. 근데 여기서는 그렇게 하는 게 아니고 여기 일렉트론 창고가 있어요. This source is electron reservoir 창고. Okay. Yeah, it can just supply electron, right? As much as wanted, okay? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, actually this electron will be supplied by the circuit, right? By the drain. So it's just something like, electron is supplied from here, right? So there must be some supply voltage. So positive, negative, current will flow like that. Those electrons can flow like that. This is the electron path, right? It can be supplied from source. No free hole associated with this MOSFET current flow. Okay? Okay, so, you know, this is still N-channel MOSFET. Those source substrate junction and drain substrate junction are always reverse biased. So, you know, they must be isolated, source and bulk, drain and bulk. This bulk must be electrically isolated for proper operation. Okay, question. Okay, let's talk about the channel inversion in more detail. This is my inversion, right? Inversion is inversion. What's a channel inversion? You know, P-type substrate suddenly becomes N-type at the surface. At the surface. Okay, surface. So what is the threshold voltage? The threshold voltage is defined to be gate source voltage, where silicon voltage drop becomes 2 pi f. Okay? Yeah, initially. You heard about the flat band condition. In a flattened condition, all the charges are zero in a MOS structure. See, yeah, if my gate voltage is a flattened voltage, yeah, this flattened voltage is, okay, let's talk about it. So this here, then, yeah, this is, so this is my gate source voltage. Gate source voltage is same as gate bulk voltage in this case. So there is no charge here. So my flattened voltage is actually, this is p-type silicon. You know, that's the same as work function difference of gate material and this substrate, the silicon substrate, okay? This substrate. This silicon substrate is now p-type, and silicon gate is now, I have n-type polysilicon. This is polysilicon. We can see the work function difference is around minus one volt, okay? Okay, let's accept this. At the flatband condition, so there is no charge here, no electric field. If I increase this gate voltage larger than in a positive direction, like minus 0.5 volt, yeah, there will be some depletion charge developed there. If I increase this gate voltage, because see, this gate voltage is more positive than substrate, it pushes away those free electron away from the surface. Positive voltage will pushes away positive charge from the surface. So surface region of silicon is depleted of free holes. Then if I further increase gate voltage, it will increase this depletion region, also this silicon potential, which is the voltage drop across silicon. Say this is integration of electric field in this depletion region. Okay. Now at the sum gate source voltage, at the threshold voltage, silicon potential becomes 2 pi f. Then this free hole here and free electron there, they are isolated from each other because of a built-in electric field. Okay. So yeah, in this case, see, I have some net charge, right? So yeah, then I can see my gate source voltage is from flattened voltage, oxide voltage, and this silicon voltage. And this silicon voltage is only 2 pi f. What's the oxide voltage? Yeah, that oxide voltage is, I can say, my from Gauss law, this is silicon depletion charge, okay? So, you know, ox is only electric field at the gate material in the oxide, and then gate oxide thickness, right? So I can calculate Vox if I know depletion charge, right? This depletion charge I can calculate by some means, something like that. That's a depletion charge if I use some Gauss law. So then my threshold voltage can be calculated that Vs is flatband voltage plus silicon voltage plus oxide voltage, something like that. This is from oxide voltage. This is from silicon voltage, okay? Yeah, that's my threshold voltage of MOSFET. Question. No question? Anyway, threshold voltage is the gate source voltage required to invert the surface of silicon into the other type, p-type substrate into n-type. Okay, if you don't have a question, let's move to the current flow. Okay. So when my gate source voltage is larger than threshold voltage, yeah, somehow my silicon potential drop is almost fixed at this voltage. See, the relation is still valid, something like this silicon plus oxide. Okay, this oxide voltage is I can say this Cox Vox. Yeah, Cox is just oh no, gamma square root of V silicon, something like that. Yeah, this is depletion charge divided by Cox, something like that. Okay. So, actually, yeah, there must be some more. Inversion charge should be there. Yeah, I forgot one term, inversion charge. Okay. Anyway, channel inversion charge can be inversion charge density. Yeah, the increase of gate source voltage over threshold voltage contribute to generate the increase of channel inversion charge. It will increase the gate source voltage. Actually, I forgot. This gate source voltage must be increased. See, because see, this gate source voltage is the Cox plus depletion charge plus this inversion charge. Okay, inversion charge. This depletion charge term is only gamma Cox V silicon, right? So I have one more term here, Qn. So this Qn can be derived like that. Okay, Qn is linearly increases with the increase of gate source voltage over threshold voltage. So in the channel, yeah, this is my source, this is my drain, and then I have oxide film here. I have a gate electrode there, and if I assume this channel region is Y equals 0, this drain region of channel is Y equals L. L is my channel length, right? At certain Y, so inversion charge here at Y, let's see. You know, the gate channel voltage at the Y equal gate source voltage and some channel voltage here, right? So I can write my gate source voltage equal gate channel voltage Y plus channel voltage drop across there. Okay, so inversion charge depends on this gate channel voltage. So gate channel, I mean inversion charge here, inversion charge at the Y position equal Cox gate channel Y minus threshold voltage. Okay. Okay, so here at the drain end, the inversion charge at Y equal L, yeah, that's Cox gate drain minus threshold voltage, right? Because here the gate channel voltage is a gate drain. Here at the source end of channel, gate drain voltage is just a gate source, right? So at the source end of channel, inversion charge is VGS minus VTH. Okay, any question until now? Question. QN이 들어갈 때는 얘일 때 이제 QN이 생겨나죠. 얘보다 작을 때는 QN은 0이에요. 0. Okay, let's talk about a little bit more about that. See, here, see. Yeah, this is my oxide. This is a silicon. Say, I have an inversion charge here. I have a depletion charge there. Inversion charge is located on the surface, right? So here, see, I have a neutral p-type, electrically neutral. See, I have a acceptor and free hole, electrically neutral. So, you know, by Gauss law, here, see, my epsilon aux e aux is sum of inversion charge plus sum of depletion charge, sum of those two. Okay? You know, this depletion charge can be written simply as gamma c aux square root of v silicon. Say, this c aux is just epsilon aux t aux. Okay? T aux is a gate oxide thickness. So this silicon voltage drop is the voltage drop across this depletion region. Depletion region. Yeah, that's a V silicon. So, you know, I know this equation. Gate, actually, I will say gate channel minus flip band voltage equal oxide potential plus silicon potential, silicon voltage drop. So when channel is inverted, this V silicon is fixed at 2 pi F. Then the other terms I mean, if I keep on increasing this value, V aux increases. You know, see, from this equation, from Gauss law, you know, this E aux is nothing but V aux plus epsilon aux. Is it right? No, T aux, sorry, T aux. So, if you substitute this equation into this Gauss equation, then what is that? Yeah, see, this is, you can derive this equation. V aux equal just C aux inversion charge, C aux depletion charge plus, inversion charge plus depletion charge plus V silicon. Okay? So, you know, this is my inversion charge, okay? This is inversion. This is my depletion charge, which is gamma C aux square root of V silicon. That's my depletion charge. So from here, you can derive a QN equation, okay? That QN equation happen to be C aux gate channel minus threshold voltage. All the terms in this equation, just I moved to threshold equation. Yeah, question. No? Okay. So let's try to derive a current equation, MOSFET current equation. Do I have some space here? Oh yeah, I have a space here. MOSFET can be considered as a voltage-controlled resistor. So you see, yeah. Let's look at the MOSFET structure. My MOSFET. Say I have a gate here. Yeah, this is my gate electrode. And then I have a silicon. This is oxide above a silicon. And then I have a source drain here. My source drain will look like that. Yeah, this is M plus source, and I have also drain there, right? This is my drain. Yeah, drain. This is a P-type substrate. My substrate contact will be somewhere. This is my bulk contact. So there will be some depletion region. Yeah, this is my depletion region. In this depletion region, I have only fixed acceptors only, no free hole, right? No free hole. But if gate voltage is larger than threshold voltage, I have inversion electrons developed on the surface of silicon, right? This amount of inversion charge density is just at y equals zero. Yeah, this equal y equals zero. This region is y equal L. Yeah, this is source end of channel. That's minus C aux gate source gate. So at the drain end of channel, so see this gate drain voltage is gate source voltage minus drain source voltage, right? So inversion charge density is larger at the source side of a channel. It is smaller at the drain side of a channel. So we can consider this is a sheet conductive charge. I have a sheet charge there, so it is a resistor, right? You know, in a resistor, the resistance value is proportional to inversely proportional to conductivity, and then the air is this is my air, right? This is my W, so this is channel W. This is my channel L. So my conductivity is actually mobility times inversion charge density there, right? Inversion charge density. That's my conductivity. So however, this conductivity changes with the channel position. So because I have a large density of free electron at the source, and then I have a small density of a free electron at the drain. So let's just make an average of it, okay? Just average of Qn y equal 0 and Qn y equal L. I assumed my gate source voltage is larger than threshold voltage. My gate drain voltage is also larger than threshold voltage, okay? So both sides are inverted. Yeah, then see, so what's my conductivity? Yeah, conductivity is half. I will substitute this one. Half C aux. You can find it. This is mu C aux VGS minus VTH minus half VDS. You can derive that. This average conductivity. Okay. Then see, I can calculate my drain current. You know, my current will flow from here to there, right? Say that there will be drain current flow. So my drain current flow will be just drain source voltage divided by resistor, okay? Yeah, then see, we can find out my drain current happened to be mu C aux W of L VGS minus VTH minus half VDS VDS, okay? So this is my drain current equation. In this condition. This is called the triode region. Yeah, the second condition corresponds to drain source voltage is smaller than gate source voltage minus threshold voltage. Okay, question. No? No question? Okay. We derived this current equation for the triode reason. Okay. So how about the saturation? See, in a triode region, the required condition is gate source voltage is larger than threshold voltage. Gate drain voltage is also larger than threshold voltage. Then my current equation equal mu Cox W of L VGS minus VTH half VDS. This is current equation for the triode region. How about saturation? The gate source voltage is larger than threshold voltage. In this case, gate drain voltage is smaller than threshold voltage. So the channel region at the drain end of a channel is not inverted. Okay, so you can derive. See, this is my gate material, gate electrode, source side, and then drain side. Okay, so this is p-type silicon, and then this is depletion region, and then see, this gate drain voltage is smaller than threshold voltage, right? Gate source voltage is larger than threshold voltage. So this part of channel is inverted. But this part of channel is not inverted. Okay? It's depleted of bridge areas. So at the sum Y, say this is a delta L. So at the sum Y, which is L minus delta L, the gate channel voltage will be threshold voltage, okay? Some gate channel voltage at the Y, L minus delta L, is threshold voltage. And then the inversion charge at this Y should be zero, right? Inversion charge is just Cox VGC minus VTH Y, right? At this Y, it is zero. So, in this case, see, I can apply the previous theory up to here. So, I can use, I can see, my drain source voltage is actually what? Drain source voltage at here, see, that drain source voltage is just this voltage, right? What's the voltage drop between this point and that point? Gate channel voltage at this L minus delta L is just a threshold voltage, right? And what's VY, L minus delta L, which is a voltage drop between this point of channel and this source end, should be VGS minus VTH. If a voltage drop between this point and this source end of channel is VGS minus VTH, then see, this is a gate source voltage, right? Then the VGC should be VTH. Okay, then for this part, I will substitute this equation, VGS minus VTH, for this VDS, and then I get my saturation current equation. Okay, any question? This is my saturation current equation. Saturation. I eat a lot and then feel happy. That's a saturation. This is actually current saturation. Current saturation. No? Okay, let's continue. So, in the saturation current equation, saturation region, gate source voltage is larger than threshold voltage. Drain source voltage is larger than, yeah, this is the same as gate drain voltage is smaller than threshold voltage. Okay. Yeah, the current equation in the saturation region happen to be so, you know, this delta L is that pinched off region. See, delta L is this is a source, this is a drain, and then this is a channel inversion region. Yeah, that depleted region is delta L, right? Out of this entire channel length L. If I increase this drain source voltage, this delta L will also increase. So I can approximate this part into something like that. So this is W of L. Yeah, this is my approximation. I will make one more bigger approximation. See, this is proportional to channel length. This is a constant. Lambda is a constant. So my most current equation in the saturation region is the final one is just this one. Yeah, this part is replaced by L. Okay, question. So my ID VDS curve will look like that. So this is VGS minus VTH. Okay. So this region is saturation. Current is saturated. This region is called triod. Eh? Triod. Triod is just this one. Okay, triode current equation is IV calculator looks like that. So it looks similar to triode operation in a triode region. Question. Drain source. Drain source가 증가하면 델타 L이 증가하죠. 왜 증가하냐면요. 그 마치 PN 장치 비슷해 가지고 요즘 끝은 항상 보면은 전압이 얼마냐 하면은 VGS 빼기 VTH로 고정이 돼 있어요. 왜냐하면 요 사이 전압은 게이트 채널이 0을 유지하는 점이니까 여기하고 여기 사이 요 채널 인버전 되는 끝하고 소스 사이는 고정이 돼 있어요. 드레인 소스하고 무관하게. 그러면 요 사이의 전압은 얼마냐 하면 드레인하고 요 끝 사이의 전압은 VDS 빼기 VGS 빼기 VTH 이렇게 돼가지고 VDS가 증가하면 요 고게 마치 디플리션 영역 같아요. PN 장전 디플리션 영역처럼 보여요. 그래서 고전압이 증가하니까 그 디플리션 영역이 증가하는 거예요. 델타 L 디플리션 영역이 증가하는 거예요. 오케이, okay, any question? Yeah. Yeah. 그래서 그게 big approximation이라 그랬는데요. big approximation, big approximation. 그게 저 아까 VDS가 증가하면 델타 L이 증가한다 그랬지. 그래도 요건 증가는 하잖아. VDS가 증가하면은 델타 L이 증가를 한다. 그래서 지금 우리가 람다 VDS를 우리가 approximation 하기를 델타 L 나누기 L이라고 가정을 해버린 거죠. 정성적으로 VDS가 증가하면 델타 L이 증가한다. 그래서 정성적으로 저렇게 간략화시킨 거예요. 뭐 그래요. 그 람다가 보면은 L에 반비례하게 돼 있어요. 이거 보면은 채널 길이가 증가하면 람다는 감소해요. 그 측정하면 알 수가 있어요. 그래서 람다는 여러분 스파이스 모델 같은 게 주어져 있죠. 람다 값이. 이 람다가 early voltage하고 같은 개념이에요. One of early voltage in the MOSFET. MOSFET에서는 이걸 channel length modulation이라 그러는데, BJT에서는 early effect라 그러죠. 같은 성질이다. 오케이, 야, question. Alright. Okay, any other question? No? Alright. Yeah, we have to finish this part in 15 minutes. Alright, so. Yeah, let's talk about the IV characteristic first. Yeah. Let's go to the current equation and then IV characteristic. Yeah, here, how come this is wrong placed? Alright, here, see? Yeah, see, when gate source voltage is smaller than threshold voltage, yeah, that current is zero. Yeah, this is a cutoff. No current flows if gate source voltage is smaller than threshold voltage. Say, if gate source voltage is larger than threshold voltage and drain source voltage is larger than this VGS minus VTH, then I have this saturation equation, right? This current is saturated. So you can see, yeah, this is a triode. This is saturation, current saturation. So I have three operating regions in the MOSFET. So if I plot drain current with respect to gate source, gate, drain source voltage, then see for see this is gate source voltage maybe 2 volt. And then if I increase gate source voltage to 3 volt, then the current equation, current will look like that. So here see, that's the boundary between, if my threshold voltage is 1 volt, boundary between triode and saturation occurs at the drain source voltage of 1 volt, right? VGS minus VTH. So here, when gate source voltage is 3 volt, the boundary between triode and saturation occurs at the VDS equal 2 volt. Okay? Yeah, this difference is proportional to GM, right? This current difference is GM delta VGS, right? Because my drain source voltage is fixed. So my delta ID equal GM delta VGS, right? Yeah, also I can say GDS delta VDS plus GMB delta VBS. I have one more term. So you can see in the saturation region, I have a largest GM, larger GM than triode region. So we need to operate the MOSFET in a saturation region for amplification. Yeah, question.그러니까 람다 디멘전이 one of volt의 디멘전을 가져요. 이게 아까 early voltage하고 같은 개념이라고 그랬잖아요. 그죠? 예를 들어 람다가 내가 0.02다 이러면 해결하잖아요. 람다가 inverse voltage의 디멘전을 가진다고. Okay. Any other question? 그러니까 여기서 이렇게 보면요, 우리는 지금 앰플리 증폭만 관심이 있으니까 Saturation Region에 우선 관심이 있어요. 여기 보면은 요 VDS가 증가하면은 요 VDS가 증가하면은 ID가 증가하겠죠, 그제? 보텀이 요거죠. 근데 VBS는 잘안 보이는데 요 속에 숨어 있어요. 그러니까 Threshold Equation에서 flat band voltage plus 2πf plus gamma square root 2πf minus VBS threshold voltage equation 이렇게 돼요. 그래서 VBS가 증가하면은 threshold voltage가 감소해서 드레인 커런트가 증가해요. 그리고 그 녀석이 GMB예요. 그래서 이걸 partial derivative ID of VBS라 그러죠. 이게 파지티브예요, 파지티브. 딴 것들이 일정할 때, 게이트 소스 볼티지, 드레인 소스 볼티지가 일정할 때. 그러니까 여기서 컨디셔널이죠. 요런 상태에서 얘의 편미분이 GMB죠. 증가한다고. 플러스예요, 플러스. 오케이. Any question? Yeah, we can go. We have around 10 slides left. So, you know, this is a large signal mode of MOSFET. So, we have derived this current equation ID, right? ID. Say, this is my gate and drain and source. I have some series resistor. No problem. I have a bulk node there. So, for this bulk drain, I have always reverse biased PN junction there, right? Reverse biased. Also, in the bulk source, I have reverse biased PN junction. So, that reverse biased PN junction is usually represented by junction depletion capacitor. They are always turned off. So I have some capacitance between gate drain, gate source, and gate bulk because of gate oxide material. This is model for large signal DC analysis and large signal transient analysis. For the small signal behavior, I have some different models. That part. ID part is replaced by my small signal ID going in there at the low frequency represented by this transconductance GM and that GDS and that GMBS. Okay. Yeah, that's a low frequency small signal current, right? And capacitance. So this is for small signal mode. Okay, question. No. So those are some parameters. I think you already know this VTO is threshold voltage at the zero of EBS. Yeah. So my threshold voltage happened to be VTO plus gamma, this is gamma, square root 2πf. Yeah, 2πf is here, this is 2πf. Minus VBS, minus square root 2πf, right? That's my threshold voltage. This is the mobility, UO. Yeah, gate oxide thickness is COX equal. This is a gate oxide capacitance per unit area. Oh yeah, here. So we want to derive small signal parameters from the current equation in a saturation region. Okay. See. Yeah. This transconductance GM, because you know this is a transconductance, right? It changed the, I mean, the controlling branch and the controlled branch are different from each other. That's a transconductance. Okay. Controlling branch is drain and source. Controlling branch is gate and source. So GM is defined to be partial derivative of ID with VGS, where VDS is a DC voltage, VBS is a DC voltage. Okay, those two values doesn't change. Okay, so you know, in a IV characteristic, IV VD characteristic, the GDS defined to be, say this is VGS equal VGS 1, and then I increase the gate source voltage, right? So at the same, for example, this is fixed VBS 0. So this corresponds to this difference at the same VDS corresponds to that GM delta VGS, right? Delta VGS is different between those two gate source voltages. So if you neglect this part, this is a zero. Then you can derive this is ID, this is half. You can derive that. Okay? So you can derive, make a partial derivative of this one. You know, this is just 2 is gone. This is 2 VGS minus VTH, right? That's just a derivative of this one with VGS. Okay. So you know this part can be represented by that. So I assume the lambda is zero in this case. This GMB thing is this GM, say I make a derivative of this one by this VGS minus VTH and make a derivative of this VGS minus VTH with VBS, right? So that's why here, this is this vector, GM. GMB is GM times this vector, which is only 0.1 or 0.3. Okay, this RO thing is just like that. This is a DC current. Look at this. Yeah, question. Yeah, question. Small signal이죠. 그래서 아까 얘기했잖아요. Small signal, low frequency, small signal drain current. GM times small signal gate source voltage. GMB times small signal base source voltage. GDS times small signal drain source voltage. 그렇게 되죠. 지엠이 훨씬 크고. 오케이, okay, question. No. All right. Yeah, see, deleted out those series register and try to simplify small signal model. Okay. So those